this tutorial, I am going to talk about the graph and how we can zoom and pan, and how we can change the panels, the size and restore. For this, I have put a graph, and I have selected on graph and change the x-axis as minus from minus pi until pi, and the offset is 0.01, and to come to those values you must uncheck auto scale, and our display format is floating point. And then our left y-axis also uncheck auto scale, and the minimum is from minus 1 to 1 with offset 0.01, and it is floating point. And then everything is okay, I suppose. I only use a callback function. I am giving the name graph callback, and then I put a command button echo and double click it on this, and I name a callback function plot cb or callback, and the label is plot, and use another command button echo, name it restore, and the callback function is restore callback, and the label is restore, and a quit button. And I have described here, I have put two labels, text message, and one of them indicated you are selecting on it, and default value to zoom, keep control key, and with the left mouse, with left mouse make a rectangle and leave. And then I use another text message and double click on it and write it to keep, to pan, keep control shift keys, and with left mouse drag. Okay, we are going on the generate. First we generate the main function, and then generate all callbacks function. And inside here, inside the C source, I am going to define two variables of type integer but static, and it is old height and old width. And in panel callback, I use the event close is quit user interface, and then I leave the functions case panel minimize, panel maximize, and restore, and I don't use any break because I don't want write anything inside the case. But when you leave it without any break, it is it has the same, all of them follows the same as event panel sizing. And inside event panel sizing, I am defining int new width and new height, and I am using get panel attribute with the panel handle and attribute width. We are going to put the new width inside the new width variable, and operate splitter. I have used two splitter, horizontal there. And you are going to double click on it and change the splitter to V splitter, and you use attach or detach controls, and all your components are here, and you select each component and select attach control on left, and you are moving that it replace in right place. When you use those buttons, you change the splitter size control to splitter move control by that arrow, and you are going to select each component. But the graph component, I want that splitter sizes control, that it's change its control, and those two messages I am going also leave it with the with move with the splitter move control, and also I use the same with the horizontal, and I am changing the name to H splitter indicated horizontal and attach or detach control, and all these components which are here, you are going to select each of them and attach controls on top, and it appear, and you can move them that they can get their place, and all those button and those texts are have the splitter moves control, while the graph has the splitter size control. I am using the operate splitter and use panel handle, panel vertical splitter with new width minus old width, and I am going to put old width equal new width, and thereafter I am going to use get panel attribute of attribute height, and you put it in new height variable, and I am going to operate the splitter to H splitter, and I am using new height minus old height, and I am going to put new height in old height variable. Then I am going to graph callback, and I am going to use event zoom. I am going to set control attribute panel graph, and I am going to use attribute zoom style, or only use the zoom style, and I am going to wall zoom to rectangle, that I am going to make a rectangle. And then I am going to use again for attribute, and I am going to enable zoom and pan as one. But what you should to do here, you must in zoom style, you must use zoom to rectangle. The default is zooming and panning disabled, but you are going to use zoom to rectangle. Okay, and inside the restore, I am going to call the set axis scaling moves function of over the graph, and I am going to wall bottom x axis, wall manual, and the same interval. I use it when I defined it, the graph, and I am going to use again for y axis, and I am going to use those interval I have chosen from the beginning. Now when we press the plot key, I need two double variable, one I and one Y, array of a double with 400 elements and an integer J. And I am going to use a for loop to fill the Y values, and it's starting from minus P unless it is P, and I am going to increment PI with P divided by 100, which is causing 201 elements. And I am going to use Y of J plus plus. I am using plus plus after, and it begins from Y 0 until Y 200. And I am going to give in that array sine of I, and because I am using pi, p and sine, I am going to add or include math.h header file, and after that I am going to plot a line in panel handle and in R graph, and the values is beginning from minus P divided by 2, and the Y value is minus 1, and this last point I want plot a line, I need 2 points. It is X first point and it is second point, and it is P divided by 2 and Y 1, and I use the color green. Now I am going to plot a waveform. You need about the plotting, you can use plotting, and it you can open it, and you have different plot opportunities: plot X, plot Y, plot XY, waveform, point, text, line, rectangle, polygon, oval, arc, and so on. And in plot waveform, I am going to plot the variable Y, which I have calculated here. And I am going, and it has a 200 elements or 201 as we accurate, and the data type is double, and the gain is 1, the offset is 0, initial value of X is minus pi, and increment is pi divided by 100, which is standing here in our for loop. It starts from minus p and incremented with p divided by 100, and I need a thin line, and the point style is empty square, and the line style is solid, one frequency point, and the color is red. When we run this, you use plot and it appears our graph, but it is very little, and I am going to select that square, and it's changed its size, and I am going to keep Control Shift, and with mouse key I draw down, and I am going to keep Control key, and with left mouse I am going to select a rectangle to see that point, and I am going to use Restore, and I am going to keep Control Shift key, and move it up with the left mouse, control key with left shift, make a rectangle, and I can see this one. And I select restore button, and I can come back to the original. I am going to select that that sign, and I am going back to my original panel. Here you can also use control key and restore, or use a shift control and move up here, there, and also see everything works. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.